Tesla has developed the world's largest decentralized battery. As well as the most recent developments in Cybertruck production, new sightings of Tesla semis, and leaks of the next generation of V4 superchargers. So let's get going. The most recent acquisition of production equipment for the Cybertruck is said to have come from a German manufacturing company who are reportedly familiar with Tesla's vehicles and facilities after supplying components and machinery to Giga Berlin and Giga Shanghai. According to these reports, Tesla is continuing to make moves in acquiring production equipment in order to build the Cybertruck in 2023. According to reports originating in Germany, the new manufacturing equipment that is being developed will be utilized exclusively for the production of drivetrain units. It has been reported that the necessary machines for the Cybertruck are currently being built, and their deployment in Gigafactory, Texas is anticipated to begin around the beginning of July 2023. It has been stated that the machinery is capable of producing approximately 750,000 drive units annually, NE fairly well with Elon's earlier estimates of the number of Cybertrucks that can be produced in a given year, which were set at 250,000. Assuming that most Cybertrucks made will have two motors, the highest-end model will have four engines. The drive unit deal and timeline align with the most recent developments from Gigapress manufacturer Idra. Idra has just completed the assembly of the first 9,000-ton press at its headquarters in Italy. This machine will be used to cast the portion of the Cybertruck's rear body that will support the bed once it has been assembled. In addition, some additional time will be required to disassemble, pack, and transport this unit before it can be reassembled in Texas. SpaceX has announced that its newest product can be purchased by individual customers. It is possible to connect to Starlink Maritime. Even when a boat is in the middle of the ocean, this high-powered form of the Starlink satellite internet terminal can send a download speed of up to 350 megabits per second to the boat. These applicants do a great deal more than just make it feasible for rich people to watch YouTube videos on their yachts. This innovation has the potential to be utilized in oil rigs, freight transporters, and commerce ships alike. In principle, it's an excellent opportunity for people who live and work at sea to have the same degree of connectivity that we take for granted here on land. People who live and work at sea will be able to take advantage of this opportunity. For those of us employed on land, having access to the internet is something we take for granted. On the website for SpaceX, it is written that Starlink Maritime allows you to connect from any place in the world, despite how remote the waters may be, just like you would if you were doing it at your office or at home. In addition to being able to withstand shallow temperatures, extremely high temperatures, hail, sleet, heavy rain, and high winds, Starlink is also competitive with rocket propulsion systems. Starlink is currently being used to obtain high-quality video of rocket landings made by SpaceX at sea. This technology provides continuous coverage in the face of engines that are capable of generating up to 190,000 pounds of force. It's possible that the video quality of the Falcon 9 booster landing caught your attention. It has undergone a significant transformation over the course of the past month. And all of this is possible because of Starlink Maritime. In the past, the live video feed from the drone landing ship would become choppy or even stop altogether right as the rocket booster was making contact with the ground, which is obviously the most exciting part of the show. However, we have been granted the opportunity to view the entire process in exquisite detail. And that is something that can be accomplished with this system. Elon Musk clarified that what we see here is not just a regular Starlink terminal that has been mounted to a boat in response that he posted on Twitter. Elon has been quoted as saying that its dual high-performance terminals are essential for maintaining the connection in choppy seas and heavy storms. In addition to the monthly fee of $5,000 necessary to utilize Starlink Maritime, a one-time hardware cost of 10 grand must be paid. In order to finish this, you will need to make use of both of the high-performance terminals. And while that may seem like a significant amount of money, Elon Musk noted that SpaceX was spending $150,000 per month for the subpar connection that they used to have on the ships in the past. Some individuals could consider this to be a significant amount of money. This comes as SpaceX has recently completed the insertion of a fresh batch of Starlink satellites into a polar orbital shell. The deployment of these 53 satellites marks the beginning of a shell number 3, which will ultimately be comprised of 348 satellites in total. In 6 different orbital planes, it will have an inclination to the equator of 97 degrees while in its operation. This is a critical stage in the process of Starlink and becoming fully functional. On Twitter, Elon stated that the polar launches would make it possible to cover the entire planet. Tesla has formed a partnership with Pacific Gas and Electric in the state of California to invite 25,000 customers to participate in the world's largest distributed battery to assist in maintaining the reliability of the power grid. This is part of Tesla's initiative to create a virtual power plant. The distributed battery is, in its most basic form, a collection of individual Powerwall home batteries that are owned privately. The homeowners decide to connect their Powerwall to the virtual power plant and give their consent. The software developed by Tesla then enables each battery in the virtual plant to work in conjunction with the others. Because of this, the entire network can simultaneously feed energy into the grid, functioning as if it were a single enormous battery. In high-stress situations, the power walls can serve as a kind of support system to keep the entire local grid from collapsing under pressure. Pacific Gas and Electric stated that their first deployment will consist of managing virtual power plant events for customers participating in the program. During May through October, the utility will instruct its customers' batteries to discharge whenever there is great demand for electric between the hours of 4 p.m. and 9 p.m. Customers of PG&E who participate in the program and have Tesla Powerwalls will receive $2 for each additional kilowatt hour of electricity that their Powerwalls discharge while the program is running. In a statement that he penned, Tesla's Senior Vice President of Powertrain and Energy Engineering, Drew Beglino, said that making it possible for Powerwall customers to contribute to the maintenance of the grid, as well as their local community, is a crucial and essential component of expediting the transition to sustainable energy. Beglino made this statement in response to a question that was posed by a member of the press. Suppose we are going to make the most of energy storage and make clean, dependable, and inexpensive electricity available to more people. In that case, the mission is to establish partnerships with utilities and government organizations all over the world. This will allow us to accomplish our aim. In addition, Tesla is working together with utility firms in the state of Texas in order to offer support for the electrical system in that state. The power system in the state of Texas is vulnerable to intense storms and other forms of natural destruction because it is not connected to any of the national grid networks. And Tesla is someone who can assist them in finding a solution to this issue. Due to how things are set up right now, homeowners in the state of Texas who have Tesla Powerwalls cannot sell any of the excess electricity they generate back to the utility company. Tesla is actively working to change that, and they are making progress. It is my hope that Texas will recognize the value that Tesla is bringing to California and will be interested in participating in the action. We have recently come across the Tesla semi on public roads, and now we are witnessing two of the electric delivery trucks traveling together on a highway close to Donner Lake in California. It is probable that these two individuals were on their way to the PepsiCo Frito-Lay facility in Modesto, which is located in California. As far as we are aware, this facility has been converted into a staging area for the initial rollout of the Tesla Semi. Taking into account both with their current location and the direction in which they were moving, it is quite possible that they were on their way there. It may not seem like much, but taking into account both of these factors, it is quite possible. This is the first location outside of a Tesla facility to have the high-powered megacharger station explicitly installed for the Semi. It was designed to accommodate the vehicle. Therefore, these are two strong contenders to become the first Tesla semis to be used for delivery to a commercial customer. It's also possible that Tesla is testing out the fleet mode concept, which is essentially like a stopgap between semi-autonomous and fully autonomous vehicles, given that two cars were driving in line. This is supported by the fact that the vehicles were moving in a line. In order for a Tesla semi to fulfill its role as a trailblazer, the design calls for a human to pilot the vehicle. After that, a string of entirely autonomous semis would trail after the vehicle that was being driven by a person and utilize it as a point of reference as they went behind it. This type of model would help to make up for some of the potential drawbacks associated with the maximum carrying capacity of the Tesla Semi, which may be decreased due to the weight of its own battery pack that it also needs to move. It's possible that the fact that the Tesla Semi also has to shift is to blame for this limitation. The next generation Tesla Supercharger V4, which has been in development for some time now, may actually have reached the point where its final design is ready to be implemented. The appearance of the charger and its dimensions have now been uncovered thanks to various sources of information. Obviously, the rate at which electric vehicles can be charged continues to be a concern for many customers. They are concerned that the vehicle will not have good range and that it will be an excessive amount of time to recharge. Even though Tesla already has the ability, thanks to their superchargers, to rapidly restore the car's battery pack at a rate that is the fastest in the industry, this is not the absolute limit of what can be accomplished with this technology. There's potential for increased speed. Energy is being produced by the V3 superchargers at a rate of 250 kilowatts at the moment, but an increase to 350 kilowatts is not far off. Elon Musk, who dropped a hint about this during the presentation of the Tesla model as played in 2021, he said, "At the moment, the installation of 250 kilowatt superchargers is actively continuing, and soon Tesla will begin to increase their capacity to 280, 300, and 350 kilowatts. Currently, a Twitter user who goes by the handle MarcoRP Tesla has been able to gain some information on what design and proportions the new V4 supercharge would have. However, he was unable to display images of it. On the other hand, he asserts that he has the measurements by contrasting the proportions of the existing V3 with those of the future V4. He devised a chart that highlighted the similarities and differences between the two of them. According to Marco, the new V4 superchargers will have a slightly smaller footprint, while also being taller and thinner than the currently used ones. That absolutely appears to be a questionable proposition. On the other hand, Drive Tesla Canada, which has shown itself to be a very reliable source of information, claims that they have obtained a photo of the new V4 charger. According to the website, they cannot publish the photo to maintain the confidentiality of their source. However, they have shared a description of what the picture will look like. The V4 superchargers will reportedly look almost exactly like the Tesla semi-mega chargers, as stated in a quote from Drive Tesla Canada. Giga Nevada and the Frito-Lay facility in Modesto both have it installed, as we have seen it there. You might be under the idea that we were shown a snapshot of the mega charger. Nevertheless, the connector itself and the area where the connector docks were the two most important differences. We have a strong assumption that the size discrepancy between the two units is principally responsible for this distinct location because it is the primary factor that differentiates them from one another. According to what we have been told, the megacharger measures in at a height that is only a few inches short of 7 feet. This suggests that the size of the docks from the ground are probably comparable, despite the fact that they give the impression of being different due to the fact that the pedestal for the V4 is not as tall as the pedestal for the megacharger." End quote. The existing V3 supercharger is said to be receiving a power update this year that will push its output all the way up to 324 kilowatts, according to the word on the street. This upgrade is reported to be taking place this year. Sawyer Merritt's tweets indicate that, in general, he may be relied upon, but he is not entirely trustworthy. This rollout is scheduled for the third quarter of 2022. Therefore, it is reasonable to assume that the output of the supercharger V4 will be at least 350 kilowatts, but it will most likely be capable of producing significantly more power than that. It is extremely improbable that we will see these releases until sometime in the year after the one that is coming up next. If you enjoyed this video, we really appreciate you hitting the like button and telling us your thoughts below. This has inspired us to create more helpful content for you. As always, we look forward to seeing you again in the following video. Thanks for watching!